Hello everyone, welcome back to Revenue Management and the topic of forecasting. Here explaining a particular occupancy forecast for one day in a month, giving you an example on how to calculate your forecast given on these particular figures here. So we're going to do an occupancy forecast for Monday, the 1st of October. In this hotel here, we have 300 rooms in our property. We're going to have 30 rooms out of order. Remember, those are deducting our availability. So we can use these figures to calculate net availability. Then we have a particular number of stayovers and arrivals, 14,150, to estimate the number of rooms sold. And we have even more detailed statistics given because we have an accurate report on estimated no-shows for this particular day, which is going to be 15, 5 early departures and 10 overstays. So 5 early departures, meaning 5 bookings are going to check out early than their originally planned checkout date, and 10 bookings or 10 guests are planning on extending their booking for at least one more night. So we can then adjust our forecast. Based on this particular cell, we're then going to calculate the rest of them down here below, meaning the occupancy percentage, how many rooms we have available, estimated forecast in revenue and RevPAR. So let's start from the top. We're going to calculate our actual availability for the day. So 300 minus 30 rooms out of order gives us 270 that we need in our capacity that we have then obviously available to sell. Now, if we have 40 stayover rooms and 150 arrivals, based on that basic method here of running a report, we would estimate 190 rooms to be sold. We need to obviously try to analyze other data and the statistics that I've just said here. How many no-shows do we have? How many early departures and overstays to be a bit more accurate? So what are we going to do? From the 190 that we just calculated, we're going to then subtract the estimated number of no-shows, the estimated number of early departures, but we're going to plus back the total number of overstays because that's an addition, again, bookings that we're getting in, so additional room nights sold. And we end up with 180 adjusted forecast. So you see a 10 room night different from 190 to 180. That's a more accurate picture based on this data given here above. Now we calculate the occupancy percentage first with the 180, our adjusted forecast. So these rooms over the total availability, 270. I have already formulated this cell as a percentage. So we know 66%, 67 occupancy. Okay, now we know the number of rooms that we have available or still left to sell. So 180 minus 270, we know that, excuse me, the other way around, 270 minus 180. So we know we have 90 rooms left to sell, and that we can express as a percentage of availability. So we can either express the 90 over total availability to get a percentage, or we can just simply take 100% minus the occupancy percentage above, exactly the same. Okay. With a forecasted ADR of 185 euros, we can now estimate our room revenue and our RevPAR as well. So first thing we're going to do is we take the ADR times the number of rooms that we have now in our forecast, 180. So we know our room revenue should be 33,300. What does that mean for RevPAR? We can take the total room revenue divided by total number of rooms available. Or if you wish to use the other formula, occupancy percentage times ADR comes up to the same figure, just to make sure you don't have a mistake in your numbers. Now, why do we have these orange cells here? If we're not going with the adjusted forecast, if we're going with the original one that we have established, the 190, we should do a comparison with those figures to find out how much of a variation there is. So if we're now doing the same calculation with 190, so 190 over 170, occupancy percentage obviously has increased because there's a 10 room difference here. How many rooms do we have left to sell? 270 minus 190, 80 rooms. Therefore, just going to go with the simple one here, we have 29%, 63 still left to sell. What does it mean for our room revenue? ADR times number of rooms sold should be higher, 35,150. And for RevPAR, there should therefore obviously be an increase as well. Let's go with occupancy times ADR as well. Okay, so we can overall see here a difference if we're comparing the two RevPARs, so actually the bottom line of how well are we doing in revenue, that there's a €6.85 difference. Now, why would we not go strategically with 190? Because it's not really realistically based on the statistics that we have already run. Most likely we'll be ending up with 180 rooms sold, more or less. So a more realistic picture are the numbers here in yellow.